Haters, haters, haters. Do you know that when people hate on you, that's okay? Listen, so many of my haters swear that they're Christian. They go around trying to pull and pick and quote verses at me and misquote things and twist things and come after me and condemn me. But listen, all these Christians are doing is they go around and condemn people all the time. They're not even sharing the gospel. They're not sharing the love. Yo, what do you think happens when you go around condemning people, putting God's name on it? That hurts them, right? That's going to turn them away from God. How is that going to draw people into God? When the Bible specifically says from God, there's no condemnation. The Bible says to feel conviction of your sin, then to repent and be forgiven. But the Bible says that guilt and condemnation is not of God. So when you go around trying to make people feel guilty and condemning them, that's not you being a Christian. Are you doing that because you think you're doing God's work? Or are you doing that to lift your own ego to make you feel a little bit better? And you guys see my comments. I have so many haters. I get crazy mean comments, but that's okay. People can hate on you. People think offensive speech is hate speech. You know what I'm saying? People think if they're offended, like they have a right to be angry and mean. Bro, what? People are allowed to disagree with you. Like disagreements are okay. That's part of free speech. That's part of having an open mind. That's part of being opinionated. Like what are the chances that every person you are going to meet is going to have the same exact opinions of you? And then people get disagreed with and they act offended. They're like, oh, they disagree. They offended me. Bro, you're really going to let someone's opinion affect you? Like someone you don't even care about, someone that don't even matter to you. You're going to let their opinion affect your whole day because they disagree with you? Bro, quit playing. Come on and be a true Christian, like pursue Jesus Christ. These people don't even read their Bible every day. They're not studying it. They're not praying. They're not spreading the gospel. They're not picking up their cross and following Jesus, which is what the Bible says. The Bible says to humble yourself, pick up your cross and follow Jesus. Guys, to be a Christian is a responsibility. It's not just this one-time decision where you believed in God. The Bible says even the demons believe in God. That doesn't mean they serve him. So it takes more than just belief. I don't know where this random theory came around that if you just believe God is real, you get into heaven. No, the Bible says you have to serve God to get into heaven. On judgment day, he'll say, welcome home, my faithful servant, or depart from me, I never knew you. So do you know God? Do you know God? Do you know he's real? Do you know him personally? Do you have a relationship with him? Yo, pursue God today. I love all you guys. I'm gonna keep spreading love to my haters. I'm gonna keep preaching the gospel. I'm gonna keep reaching them. Yo, because we're changing lives. We're saving lives and we're changing. Let's go.